Alright, boys and girls, welcome back to a new Alpha Star video. Today we will have a look at the Alpha Star Zerg in the bottom left corner. And in the top right, spawning as the Blue Terran, is a Grandmaster player on New Repugnant CLE. And let's have a look what this Grandmaster player can do for us. As last time we watched an Alpha Star Zerg replay, we saw a quick Roach Queen push against the Protoss. Let's see if he has similar plans in this ZVT game or if he has some other strategies. I'm very curious to see, as I haven't watched a lot of the Alpha Star Zerg. I would love some new Alpha Star replays on the new map pool to see what Alpha Star will do there, especially the Protoss version, as that was by far the strongest of the three. Love to see what he has in store, and I would have loved if he would have been able to, you know, stay on the ladder a little bit longer, perhaps get higher on the ladder, but sadly that's not the case. Maybe we'll get more Alpha Star replays in the future, but for now we'll have to do with what we got. And that's the ZVT on New Repugnant CLE. Starting once again with that 17 hatchery that Alpha Star so desperately loves for whatever reason. All professional players prefer 16 hatch as it can queue up the queens at the same time. It just feels nicer, faster creep, faster links from that natural hatchery as well. But Alpha Star always going for that 17 hatch. We have a barracks in a very odd position here, I have to admit. I've never seen this one before. Usually you always see Terrans build that barracks at the ramp. So they can wall with it in case some kind of early Ling attack happens. Of course, he is scouting with an SCV, so he could, in theory, still float that barracks there if he scouts something useful with his SCV, but it's not going to be the case as Alpha Star is just opening up safe and solid. Uses the two overlords to scout for any kind of proxy barracks as well. Even though if the proxy barracks were straight in front of his base, he actually would be in a little bit of trouble. Or even over here, he wouldn't even have found them. So a rather odd overlord pattern as he continues on to the natural and perhaps the main base of the Terran player with his two overlords. The Terran spots the hatchery timing, even goes into the main to check the spawning pool and is like, all right, I know what this is. I can just go back home and play a standard macro game from this. So we do see a Reaper into a reactor. This was from a gas first, and at this point in time, battlecruiser openers are very popular. We still see some Hellion Banshee as well, or just some six Hellions into Viking, perhaps triple CC. So curious to see what the Terran will do there. Reaper makes his way across the map, will be jumping up this little cliff and try to do some damage, either onto a drone or perhaps some links that are over here. First drone will fall, poor micro there by the Alpha Star. Queen isn't out yet. Second drone is under attack, as I accidentally pressed the wrong hotkey. So once again, we'll look at the first drone falling. Second drone under attack. Oh, pulls a lot of drones and micros this properly. Shouldn't lose another one. Oh, yeah, does manage to build a spore and save one of the drones. Proper save there. Now, what does Alpha Star do with the queen? In professional play, it's most common to see a creep tumor first with the first queen at the natural. Alpha Star, however, preferring for that initial inject, will be getting a lot of larva with that, but shouldn't be able to actually spend those larva, as usually you just don't have the money available if you continue queen production. A couple of links on the other side of the map will be able to get in, because once again, there is no wall. Hellion should be able to deal with this as the Reaper is trying to get another kill. Actually does get the kill, as you can see on the kill count. Hellions will be able to deal with this. Alpha Star, however, will force a full pull on all of those SCVs and will even kill an SCV, I believe. Even two SCVs go down, so pretty decent trade. Two links for two SCVs and a full pull, which always cost about 100 minerals or maybe 80, 85 minerals. So it's rather expensive. But the game continues as normal. We see a quick second gas as well from our Terran player, so most likely indicating some kind of heavy starport tech, whether that be a fusion core or maybe banshees with cloak or maybe a raven, something like that. We also see a very quick roach warren from the Alpha Star with another queen in production, which should be the third queen, I believe. Yeah, four Hellions trying to poke forward, looking as to where that third base is. Not over here. Is he aware? No. He might be thinking that it's a two base all in at this point, which it kind of is. This is a two base all in with a fake third. I mean, it's 33 workers, five roaches are in production. And the third base is done. So the Terran will scout this and be like, ah, that's all safe. This is a third base. We'll use the Reaper to scout, sees the Roach Warren, and we'll see a bunch of roaches pop. Throws down a fusion core in response at home. So we'll be going for that battlecruiser. Should be starting to throw down bunkers, I can only imagine, as well as get a tank. Yes, does switch the factory towards the tech lab. barracks onto the reactor. I wouldn't be surprised to see two or three bunkers started with the 400 minerals that are in bank right now. These Hellions should be able to delay any kind of Ling movement that could be making its way across the map. So you want to make sure that the Lings have the same speed as the Roaches. So you want to delay those Lings from going across the map with your Hellions. Try to do some damage on them, make sure that they stay with the Roaches. So you can see he's poking up, he's poking down, trying to find those Lings, but the Lings are already on the other side of the map right now. Do get spotted by these cars. Hellions, together with the Viking, will get some good vision of those Lings, trying to get some damage in. Viking is actually doing a bunch of damage on these Overlords, and Alphastar not sure what he wants to do. It's actually being a little bit hesitant. With those attacks, usually it's key to straight up move across the map, because the longer you wait, the more tanks are out. One tank is already in position right now. There's no Overlords in position either to actually gain high ground vision on these tanks, so no Biles can raid down. We do see Hellions target firing onto those Lings. Some good micro coming out of the Terran player, who's focusing on the Ravager with his tanks, with the Hellions onto the Lings. Queens are making their way across the map, but they're nowhere near the fight actually. Tank gets unseached because he's afraid of a walk up the ramp into Biles. A lot of workers go down. There is a third CC on the way. And there's already two orbitals done. So even though our Terran player loses a lot of workers, this is kind of okay, honestly, as his battle cruiser has started. It isn't done quite yet, but he hasn't lost enough units or enough workers yet to be very far behind. Once this second orbital finishes and he can start triple SCV production again, throw down a couple of mules, he should be in kind of an okay position as long as he doesn't die. I mean, how many queens is there down? There's still some queens injecting, but this feels very, very all in from Alvastar, who finally starts producing a couple of extra drones. Viking does get repaired, and we have a couple of mules still remaining. Battle cruiser is, well, 90% done at this point. And I mean, at this point, once you get your third tank, you should be pretty safe being a Terran player, no? Viking should be able to deny this high ground vision with the Overlord, and I don't really see a way for Alphastar to walk into three tanks and a battlecruiser, to be quite frank. Well, battlecruiser makes its way across the map. Oh wow, that's a very ballsy play. Instead of going for the safe defense and knowing for sure that it can hold, instead he counterattacks, kills the only queen that's in the main base, no spore there yet, just starts right-clicking drones. I think this is absolutely the superior play, and a lot of people wouldn't have thought of it. They would have instead used the battlecruiser to defend, but this was way better. He saw three queens on the other side of the map and realized, hey, wait a second, there's probably no queens, or maybe a couple of queens, two, three queens on the other side of the map defending, and now all of these drones are gonna die. Sure, the spores finish, but the amount of armor and the amount of health that his battlecruiser has just means he's gonna be able to target down drones. That's exactly what he's gonna be doing. Alphastar decides to eat his losses, basically, and just kind of move back. For Overlord, still in very forward position, as this battlecruiser absolutely ravages his main mineral line. 16 worker kills, some of them Ling kills and Ravager a queen, but I mean, all of these kills, they're not Lings, you know. It's not like this was cheap for Alphastar to lose. Like, units lost right now is 4k resources lost for Alphastar, and only 1800 lost for our Grandmaster Terran player, who is absolutely destroying these drones. I mean, it looked so good for Alphastar during the push, even though he never got very far ahead worker wise, still looked like the push was at least somewhat successful. But at this point, I mean, we have a second battlecruiser joining, which will be able to target down even more workers. Here we go, more drones falling down. Queen will be targeted down as well. Is there Yamato yet? No, Yamato hasn't been upgraded, so no one-shotting of the queens is yet possible. And this battlecruiser is being microed well as well. You see him just skirting around the edges of spore range. It's got hit a little bit there. Where's that first battlecruiser? Is it at home? Yes, being repaired, probably teleported back home. Tanks dealing perfectly fine with these Ling and Roach Ravager attacks. Once again, this Alphastar is just continuously attacking with Queen, Roach, Ravager, not really planning to macro whatsoever, which is kind of weird to see, honestly. There's pretty awful creep threat as well for this point in the game. Overlord just randomly being rallied across the map, and just no clue how to deal with air units, to be quite honest. Like, very improper defense against air units, as we saw against the Protoss player as well. There he managed to win with the Queen Ravager play, but I don't think he's going to be so fortunate this time around, as I mean, he's just completely supply blocked. Looks like 7 or 8 Overlords to these battlecruisers. Look at his battlecruiser. 37 kill on this one battlecruiser. He's an absolute hero. He's going to get a hero's welcome back at the SCVs. Didn't even take any damage in this current mission as well. Already got repaired one, so he has some experience. Seen a lot back in the war. We have this Viking as well. This Viking's a hero. All of these are overlords that would have otherwise been spotting the high ground to kill the tank up here. So absolutely very useful and very vital for this game as well. Alpha Star is like, you know what? I've tried a bunch of Road Ravager pushes already. Let's continue with the same plan because it's going so well. I'm down 10 workers. I have no creep on the map. My army sucks. I have no clue what he's doing. And I still have zero anti-air except for queens. And here he goes again. Starts rallying overlords across the map. Starts rallying Ravagers and Roaches into three battlecruisers. And just complete cluelessness on what to do against battlecruisers. This guy has to be thinking like, what is the Zerg player smoking? And well, to be fair, computers can't really smoke anything, so I don't think he's been smoking too much. But yeah, this is not the way you want to be. It's just not the way you want to be. More overlords going down. How many overlords have fallen already? 15 overlords have gone down, and almost all of these have gotten sniped on this side of the map as well, just moving there for no reason whatsoever. More Roaches being rallied towards their death. This is absolutely unbelievable. Just unit after unit just dying for free. Three Yamatos finally do go off, do snipe three queens, and another overlord just goes down. I mean, this is a complete massacre. 20 army supply against 84 right now. And officer is just completely dead. More drones are falling. And he's just gonna win the game with three battlecruisers. 15 kills, 16 kills, and 47 kills respectively. So 80 kills shared between these three battlecruisers. Absolutely bananas. And none of these kills were really links. Maybe one or two links went down against the battlecruisers, but the rest is just Roaches, Ravagers, Queens, and Drones. I mean, the Terran is up 70 supply, probably wondering why his opponent isn't leaving. And honestly, I'm also wondering why his opponent isn't leaving, as this looks absolutely over. Right now he has 6 Roaches and 2 Ravagers on the map, and 6 Queens as well to try and deal with those 4 battlecruisers who are still running completely rampant everywhere. Third base has gone down, no more workers left there. Fourth base workers will die as well, and there's still some creep remaining, but I mean, he has no units. This is absolute destruction by the Grandmaster Terran player, who definitely found the weak spot of the Alpha Star, which is the complete lack of anti-air. GG gets called, and the Grandmaster Terran player wins. So another interesting strategy here by Alpha Star, who opts to once again go for a Queen Roach pool. Didn't work out, but you know, you can't have it all. Well played to the Terran player, and I'll see you boys with the next video. Bye bye.